So far, we have discussed about every entity in the nature. We talked about human beings, we talked about animals, plants, you know, soil, air, water. So when we go on to discuss existence, just try to imagine what remains to be discussed. When we have talked about the complete nature, right, what else is to be included in terms of existence that we have to explore, right? So this is something that we have to think, we can start thinking over it. So maybe I can have some responses in the chat box. What remains to be discussed? When we have discussed the complete nature, what remains to be discussed in terms of existence, which is remaining, which we have not discussed so far? You can message in the chat box. I'm just asking what remains to be discussed. Let us start thinking over it. What remains to be discussed in terms of existence, which has not been covered so far? Okay, probably I could not make it clear. Anyway, fine. Okay, yeah. So our role in the daily routine to preserve nature, that is again to do with nature, conservation, again to do with nature, right? Impact of humans on earth, that is again to do with nature. Material to be avoided for environmental conservation, again to do with nature. So let's start thinking what remains to be discussed. That is something we have not discussed so far. Try to reflect on this. There is something which is existing, which has not been covered so far. What is that? Anyway, we keep on exploring on this, right? So we'll go to discuss this further. So the next level that we are going to discuss is harmony in the existence, and the process is the same, taking whatever is being said as a proposal and then verifying it on the level of our natural acceptance, and then also living accordingly to validate in our life, you know, so that it leads to right understanding. So existence, if you see, existence is exist plus essence. Existence is whatever exists, you know. So exist means to be something which is there. Now if you look at the essence, right, it is harmony. So far we have been exploring about harmony, and you could see that harmony is there at every level, be it human being, be it family, be it society, be it nature. So the essence of all that exists is essentially, if you see, harmony. And we can split the word existence like this, exist plus essence. So also, if you try to pinpoint all that we have discussed in terms of harmony at different levels, we can sum it up by saying coexistence. So existence is coexistence. This is something that we are going to explore. So there are units, you know, and we talked about different kinds of units, classifying them into four orders. But there is another entity called space, which we have not covered so far. We could not discuss, you know, so far. So there's something called space, and space is also there. And the units are submerged in space. So if you look at the units, you know, for example, my body is a unit. I am a unit. You know, this computer is a unit. This mouse is a unit, right? Whatever, the table lamp, whatever I can see in the room is a unit. And we can see that all these units are there in space. There is space between these units, and there is space inside the unit. For example, you take this mouse, you know, and there is space all around this mouse. You break the mouse, and you can see that there is space inside the mouse also. Now, as we have studied about atoms and molecules, we can see that this mouse is made up of atoms and molecules. Now, between every two molecule, there is space. Within every molecule, there is space, right? And within every molecule, there are atoms. Now, for an atom also, you can see that around the atom and there is space. Inside the atom, there is again space. The subatomic particles are there very much in space. So this space is something which is there everywhere, and every unit in the nature is submerged in space. The space is inside the unit, the space is on the periphery of the unit, the space is outside the unit. And when you look at this, the celestial bodies like the Earth, you know, Moon, Sun, all these are there. Inside the Earth also there is space, outside the Earth also there is space, and there is no point in this existence where there is no space. The moment you say that the space is up to here and not there, it means you are able to see there, and there is space already existing there. The space is, you know, all pervading, you know, not having any limit, and every unit is there in space. And this space is a real entity. And now as we explore, we can see how the units are self-organized being in space, how the units are, you know, having a definite conduct being in space. So this is something to be understood, right? And being in space only, the unit is able to recognize its relation with every other unit, right? And to fulfill the relation accordingly. So the essence of that is, which we are going to discuss now, is coexistence. So existence is there, you know, all that exists. Units are there, space is there, and units are submerged in space. So when you look at the units, you can see that they are limited in size. Just try to think of any unit, you know. Every unit is limited in size, isn't it? So everything that is there in the room is limited in size. You go to see the complete, you know, planet, and that is also limited in size. It has a radius, it has, you know, a periphery, right? So a planet is also limited in size. So we can see that every unit in this existence is limited in size, but the space is unlimited. It's all pervading. You know, there is no limit to it. Can we see this, right? That space is unlimited, all pervading. Now every unit is an activity in itself. When I look at my body, it is an activity in itself. So many activities are going on in the body, isn't it? So the heart is beating, the pulses are, you know, working, right? Digestion is taking place, blood circulation is taking place, isn't it? So every unit is an activity in itself. Similarly, we can see the units of the physical order. Similarly, we can see the units of the animal order, you know, bio order. They all are an activity in themselves, and every unit is active in relation to every other unit. So we can see, you know, how one unit is interacting with the other unit. For example, the heart is there, it is regulating with other parts of the body. So heart is an activity in itself and is active with other, you know, parts of the body. The body is a unit, an activity in itself, and it is active with air, water, you know, all these things, the other material things in the, you know, house. So it is active with other units. So every unit, you know, even if you try to look at the atomic and molecular level, you can see that it is an activity in itself. And we have studied also about atoms and molecules. So they are an activity within themselves, and they are active with other units. And that's how we can have the reactions, either physical or chemical, taking place, isn't it? And there are two kinds of units in this complete existence, right? One, the material units, and the other is the conscious unit. So I am also a unit, right? My body is also a unit. I am an activity within myself, and I'm active with you. So when I'm interacting with you, this is being active in relation to you. And within myself, I have desire, thought, expectation. So I'm an activity within myself. See, every unit you can see is an activity in itself and is active with other units. While in space, if you see, this is no activity. You know, space is no activity. There's nothing like what is taking place in my body or in me, you know, that is there in space. It remains as it is. Okay, there is no increase or decrease there. There is no composition or decomposition there. It remains as it is. So it is called no activity, kriya shunya. Now we can further study that every unit being in space is energized. Right? So every unit is energized. Our body is energized. I am energized. You know, every physical unit is energized. You turn on the light and it glows. Right? How? Because it is energized. Every molecule is energized. Every atom is energized. And how is it energized? Being in space. So every unit you can see, you know, try to think of any unit and you can see that there is energy in it. And you can also see that the energy in a unit, you know, increases or decreases. So there is a fluctuation in energy. So when you feel excited, you have one level of energy. When you feel depressed, you have another level of energy. You do not provide food to the body has one level of energy. You provide food to the body, body has another level of energy. So this energy is relative. It keeps on, you know, increasing or decreasing. So the energy that is there in the units, you know, is increasing or decreasing. And being in space, every unit is energized. Similarly, you can see that every unit being in space is self-organized. You just see how self-organized our body is. We just put food inside the stomach. Rather in the mouth, it goes to the stomach, gets digested, and every part of the body keeps on working, right, in a self-organized manner. isn't it? You can just see how finely, you know, the heart is working, the pulses are working, the limbs are working, the our, you know, various systems in the body are working, and they are all self-organized. In a similar manner, we can see the house is self-organized. You construct a house, it remains in a particular shape, right? The house is so well-organized. The tree is so well-organized. You just plant the seed, it grows into a sapling and then a plant and then a tree. It is so well-organized, right? You do not have to make every cell grow, isn't it? You do not have to make every cell of the body work. You do not have to make every limb, every organ of the body work. It is working by itself in a self-organized manner. The self also, if you see, that is I, you know, I'm self-organized. How come? If you see, the moment I have some desire or thought or expectation which is not in coherence with my natural acceptance, I feel unhappy. And the moment they are coherent, they are harmonious with the natural acceptance, right? I feel happy. Now, this is a self-organization available in me. The moment I think of opposition, I feel unhappy. The moment I think of values in relationship, I feel happy. Now, how come we are able to reflect, you know, on whatever is being proposed in this workshop so naturally, and we are able to see that, yes, this appeals to me? Because we are self-organized. It's only that we have not paid proper attention to the self-organization, isn't it? So the self, you know, is also self-organized. The body is also self-organized. Each and every material unit is also self-organized. And you can also see that every unit is recognizing its relation, you know, with other units and fulfilling it, right? And how come is it happening? Being in space. And this way, every unit is an organized order, right? In an order in itself and participating in the larger order. So whatever we have discussed so far, if you look at it, you know, we are just trying to unravel the orderliness which is already there in the nature, being in space. So when we say that, you know, I naturally want to make the other happy, the other naturally wants to make me happy. So it means there is a relationship already existing between me and you, right? Between one human being and the other human being, one self and the other self. That relation is already existing. We just need to fulfill it. For that, we just need to recognize it, you know. And we can see that even if I do not recognize it rightly, I'm able to accept it very naturally within me. So the only task is to, you know, recognize it rightly so that I am able to fulfill it. And even if I do not recognize it rightly, I at least recognize it, maybe through preconditioning or sensation. So that recognition is already taking place. So between every two units, this recognition is taking place of the relationship. You know? So for the material units, since there is no activity of assuming there, there is no activity of knowing there, so it is very much definite. Now in the self, since there is an activity of assuming there, so the recognition depends on the assuming, and the recognition can be definite only on the basis of knowing. So this way, every unit in the existence is recognizing the relation with every other unit and fulfilling it. You know, so when you try to look at this, you know, we can understand how this whole nature is submerged in space. And if you can, like when you look at the energy part also, so you can see that every unit is energized by itself. You know, now one may say that the earth gets energy from the sun. Okay, very nice. Where does the sun get energy from? So we say that it is getting from fusion, from hydrogen to helium, fusion is taking place, and that's how the sun is emitting energy. Very nice. And from where the hydrogen is getting energy? So at some point of time, you have to say that no, it is self-energized. So why not talk about the same way for Earth also? So there is some exchange of energy taking place between Earth and sun, that is fine. So that exchange of energy is always there, right? But the unit is also self-organized, self-energized. So the earth is self-energized. Every, you know, molecule, every atom of the soil is self-energized. It's also getting energy from the sun, you know, because there is a relation between earth and sun through which this fulfillment is taking place. Similarly, if you look at the self-organization part, you know, if we had to organize our whole body, right, to work in a particular manner, then just think how chaos would have happened, you know, right? So if you go to a friend's house and you just forget your, you know, hand there, that, and then you called your friend that I forgot my hand at your house, kindly return it to me. We are so forgetful. You can just see, we are not able to appreciate this, you know, how self-organized our body is, how self-organized our plant is, right? How self-organized the kitchen utensils are, that you just have to turn on the lighter and the food gets, the pan gets hot and the food starts getting heated and gets cooked. You don't have to make each and every molecule cooked. This is something to be appreciated. There is some echo coming. Rajul bhaiya, my voice is coming. Gajen sir?
Yeah, there okay. is an echo because perhaps there are two connections.
Okay, okay.
And both of them are transmitting.
Okay, so presently this is fine?
Yeah, now it is fine.
Okay, bhaiya. So we need to appreciate how every unit is energized, self-organized, recognizing its relation. Right? We take it for granted that this is very much there, right? But ultimately, how come it is there? That we have to understand, that we have to see. And when we look at it closely, we can see that this all is there being in space. Space is at the base, you know? And being in space only, every unit is energized, self-organized, and recognizing its relation with every other unit. So when we have advanced level workshops, then we are able to discuss it further because there may be so many questions coming from here, right? So in this limited time, we'll not be able to elaborate on every detail of it. But this is something which we needed to bring into your focus so that you are able to appreciate this. You are able to look into this. Now, when we look at the whole existence with this understanding, we can see that existence is coexistence, you know, and there are units which are submerged in space. This space is all pervading, right? While the units, if you see, they are limited in size. So every unit is limited in size. You know? Space is unlimited, right? Every unit is an activity in itself. The space is no activity, right? Every unit being in space is self-energized, self-organized, energized, and recognizing its relation with the other unit and fulfilling it. Now, if you look at the units, there are two kinds of units. One is the material unit, the other is a conscious unit. When you look at the material units, we can see that their composition keeps on changing, right? So they are all temporary. While if you look at a conscious unit, the self, it is continuous. Its needs are continuous, its activities are continuous. You can also see that in the material units, only two activities are taking place, recognizing and fulfilling. So we observe this about our body in a similar manner. We can observe this for the rest of nature. While discussing the nature, we had a glance on this where we could briefly explore this. Now, when you go to explore other units in the nature, we can see that there is only scope for recognizing and fulfilling in the material units. When you look at the conscious unit, the self, we can see that there are four activities: knowing, assuming, recognizing, and fulfilling. So when you look at the activities in the nature, in the material units, there are only two activities, which are recognizing and fulfilling. And in the conscious unit, there are four activities. And you can see that we can understand this reality only when I'm able to see myself different from the body, isn't it? So that clarity of the distinction between self and body is quite important. The more I'm able to see it clearly, that I'm not the body, I'm with my body. I'm a conscious unit, body is a material unit, and my body is like this. I am like this. Similarly, every material unit is like this. Now, when you look at the material units, you can see that there are two orders here, physical order and bio order. So if you look at the physical order, the smallest unit of the physical order is atom, which is an order in itself. The smallest unit in the physical order, which is an order in itself. If you look at the subatomic particles, they are not an order in themselves. That's why they appear always charged. But when you look at the atom, it is a unit which is an order in itself. And these atoms combine to make molecules, right? And these molecules combine to make molecular structures. And these molecular structures are of two kinds, lump and fluid. For example, this building is a lump. And the mountains are a lump, right? Whatever structure we see, molecular structure, big molecular structures, they are a lump. And then there are fluids like water, air, these are all fluids. Now, these fluids go to nurture or fulfill the need of a cell. So, these fluids nurture the cell. And also, you can say that the fluids combine to make the cell, which is the smallest unit for the bio order. So, these cells combine to make plant. So, one kind of constitution, one kind of structure of the cell makes a plant. Another kind of constitution of the cell makes the animal body. Another kind of constitution of the cell makes the human body. So while studying nature, we could see that there is bio order, there is animal order, there is human order. And we could see that the bio order if you look at it, and the animal body and the human body are all the same. For example, my body is same as a plant. You could not discuss all the orders in much more detail so that we could explore into their innateness, their natural characteristics, their inheritance, their activities. You know? When you try to explore them, so generally we discuss this when we have ample time, for example, in a 8-day workshop. In fact, when we have higher level workshops, then we also explore these in much detail. Right? So the plant has activity of, you know, respiration and it grows. In a similar manner, the animal body has activity of respiration and it grows. The human body, like my body, also has activity of respiration and it grows. Now the animal body combines with the conscious unit to make the animal order. The human body combines with the conscious unit to make the human order. So here we have the four orders. So we can have a look at the complete nature in one go when we are able to look at this. So how this whole nature is constituted, right? So this animal order, you can see, as we discussed yesterday also, is coexistence of a body and a self. There is no self here in the bio order. There is no self here in the physical order. There is self, of course, here in the human order. Now, we can also see that animal order has primarily the will to live. But if you look at ourselves, we have the will to live with, you know, happiness. And for that, what is required is right understanding and right feeling. Right? So the exercise that we are doing right now, and something that we have to do inevitably in education, is to ensure the right understanding and right feeling. So when I'm able to do this, you know, then I'm able to have a conduct which can be termed as definite, which can be termed as humane, so that I'm able to live with human consciousness. Now, this is actually the meaning of development. This is acyclic. For example, if you understand something, you can never forget it. You can never get omitted. If you understand what is trust, and you are able to see very clearly without any iota of doubt or any mixing of thoughts that no, the other person naturally wants to make me happy. It's not that you have to carry it in your memory, or you have to keep in mind, or you have to remember from time to time, or you have to carry it as a burden on you. No, it becomes a part and parcel of your understanding. So whatever we understand is a one-time development. It happens and it is very much there with me in continuity. So similarly, whatever I understand, whatever I am able to contemplate as right feeling, it remains in me forever. And that's why this is acyclic. And it can never go back. It is linear. And this is actually the meaning of development. Something that will not go back again. So this is the meaning of development. Here, if you see, whatever is happening is cyclic. As you could see, the physical order, soil, goes to make the plant, and the plant again decomposes to back to the soil. So there is a cyclicality involved here. In the plant, there is cyclicality. There is animal body where there is again cyclicality. In our human body also, we can see there is a cyclicality. It is said that our cell has a life of, let's say, 6 months, if I'm correct. And it again gets disposed of from the body as a fecal matter and goes back to the soil where the plant grows. And from there itself, we are again taking food. So there is, of course, a cyclicality involved here. There is cyclicality here also. You build up a house, a 27-story building, right? And tomorrow an earthquake comes and the whole building goes back to the earth, right? From where it came. So there is a cyclicality here. Now we can see that wherever the process is cyclic, there can be no development. It can be an aid to development, right? But there is no development here. So whenever we are talking about development, we have to focus on the human being. We have to focus on the self, that the transformation takes place. Because there is only the self where the transformation is possible, where the development is possible. In all these units, there is no development possible. Because there is always a scope for going back to the original state. And this is good also in itself, because through this cyclic process only, we are able to fulfill the need for physical facility. So with this understanding of the complete nature, now we have the right kind of program to be made. So you can see that this whole thing is already in harmony, and only this part is remaining, and it has to happen in the self, by the self, something that we are trying to do. So this whole thing is already in harmony, right? And only that I have to work within myself. isn't it? And we can also see that there is no scope for development in the rest of nature. It will go back to its original state, right? Only this is the entity in the entire existence where the development can take place. So next time when we have to make a program for development, you know, we have to see where we have to focus. So our programs for development at the national level, at the international level, at the state level, at the institutional level, you know, cannot be only in terms of this. This can be an aid. So when we are making a building, it can be aid to the process of right understanding for the student, right, or the faculty or anybody else, right? The building in itself is not a development, right? Whatever structures we are making from physical order, or whatever we are doing in terms of bio order, or whatever we are doing in terms of animal order, can at most be an aid to development. So next time when we have to make a program for development for our institution, we have to focus here at the development of the self, right? In a similar manner, when we have to make a program for development of the nation, we have to again look here. If the self is not getting developed and only these things are getting, you know, new and new, you know, designs are being made, new and new, you know, technologies are evolving. So ultimately, you know, it may or may not suffice to develop myself. So for example, this Zoom app, if you see, it is some kind of innovation in the physical order, right? And with that innovation, we are able to communicate. But this Zoom app is not a development itself. Ultimately, what we are going to discuss through this app, you know, lets us develop. So this is an aid to development. These are all computers, these gadgets, you know, whatever, vehicles, whatever we are designing, we are developing, you know, or let us say manufacturing, they are only an aid to development. So this is something which we have to have at the focus when we talk about development. Nice. So maybe we can take the questions at the end. So to sum up, existence is in the form of coexistence. It is ever present. You know? And as we said, the essence of the whole existence is coexistence. And we'll slowly see that whatever I have discussed so far was only an elaboration of coexistence. And there are units there which are submerged in space. Every unit in the existence is related with every other unit in existence in a mutually fulfilling manner. Synergy is intrinsic. Synergy, that is harmony, is intrinsic to existence. Harmony and relationship is inherent in nature. We do not have to create it. We do not have to construct it. The role of human being is to realize this coexistence, this harmony, this relationship. For this, all that human beings need to do is to understand the coexistence in the existence and to live accordingly. And living accordingly would mean to live with the feeling of coexistence, right? So if you see from where we started, so right understanding would mean to understand coexistence, you know. Relationship would mean to live with human being with coexistence. And when it comes to ensuring the fulfillment of physical facility, it means ensuring coexistence with the rest of nature. And we can also see that there is every provision in the existence for living in coexistence. So one thing to be appreciated here is that there is already a coexistence there in the existence. I only have to align with it. Somehow, due to lack of right understanding, I have got misaligned. And that alignment is not there with the coexistence. And I only have to align myself. So through my education, I can align myself. But if through education, I am getting preconditioned, right? Then that alignment is at risk. I am not going to align myself with the coexistence. So this is something, you know, to be looked into, how I can align with the coexistence. This coexistence is there with my family members, with the society, all the units in the nature, right? Only that I have not looked at it correctly. Only that it was not at my focus throughout. Now I have to focus on this. So the moment I am able to see the whole reality as it is, then these two activities which were dormant get activated. So realization would mean I'm able to see the coexistence in the existence in completeness. I'm able to see the submergence of nature in space, something that we discussed right now. When I'm able to see the submergence of nature in space, then I'm able to understand the harmony in the nature at all the levels. So this understanding becomes complete, which was only partial with lack of understanding of submergence. It becomes complete. You know? Then these two get activated, and this is right understanding the self. So from day one, we have been talking about right understanding, but to locate in the self, you know, we can see that the activation of realization and understanding in the self is right understanding, right? And with that, what will happen at the level of desire, contemplation will take place of the values. So far we have been analyzing the values, we have been thinking about values, we have been imaging about the values, but the realization understanding will enable the contemplation of the values in the self, right? And with that, all these abilities of desire, thought, and expectation will again get aligned with the realization, understanding. The alignment that I am seeking within me will be there very much in me in continuity. So my complete content of imagination will be guided by right understanding. You know? And then my competence is completely in coherence with this coexistence. So I can contemplate coexistence, understand coexistence, you know, live with coexistence. And that is the state of continuous happiness, continuity of harmony in me, in all my interactions, with in behavior, in work, right?